Ramsey. Broughton having trouble with it. Out to the point to Starikov. His slap shot is wide. Vasilia can't handle it. Cleared down into the Soviet end by Brakota. But an icing call coming up here as the touch is made by Starikov. With 6 minutes gone in the second period, the Soviet Union leading the United States 3-2. The Harlamov, Petrov, Mikhailov line out there for the Soviet Union. The line that has skated together on the Central Army team for the last 9 years. The Soviets with a 20-man roster, 11 of those players play on the same team in the Soviet Union. Of course, the Americans with 9 fellas either formerly or currently with the University of Minnesota. But a great disparity in experience. Baker. Back to center ice, Vasiliev now in over the blue line for the Soviets. Vasiliev off Baker's skate, and Johnson able to clear the zone as Starikov goes back to get it.
The Soviet line has played together for 9 years, but it's a very different line than it was 9 years ago. It plays much more as a line and has much less individual brilliance, particularly Kharlamov, who with age and with 2 broken ankles suffered in a car accident, has slowed down considerably.
Of course, that is the basic Soviet philosophy. Teamwork, teamwork, teamwork. If there's one player who's more of an individual than any other, it would probably be number 19, Balderas. Fedosov, number 2 for the Soviets. To Golikov. Alexander Golikov taken out of the play by Johnson, and Baker clearing it back to center ice. This is Fedosov again. Vyacheslav Fedosov, 21 years old, has passed up ahead to Golikov. Golikov able to get there first on the icing call. His brother then centers it, and Makarov couldn't get his stick on it as Craig was out of position. Now to Fedosov, moving in from the point. Shot deflected in front. Wide.
Here's where the U.S. team has to get control, make sure they get it out of their zone.
And that's exactly what Silk does. We'll have a faceoff as he clears it into the seats. 12 minutes and 33 seconds remaining in the second period.
There's Golikov sweeping around the net, finding his man in front, but the puck just goes off his stick wide of the net.
The Soviets on top, 3-2. Pavlich on the faceoff. Back out to the point, Fedosov, the slap shot is blocked in front. Krutov, number 9, losing it. Swept into the center zone by Harrington, but Fedosov back to control for the Soviets. Maltsev with Pavlich. Baker trying to move it up along the board. Lebedev keeping it in for the Soviets. The puck comes loose, and now Harrington on the breakaway. Harrington against Mushkin, and he's wide with a shot. So Harrington on the breakaway had a chance to tie the game, but now Schneider, and his shot goes through the crease. Morrow can't keep it into the point. The Americans will have to clear the zone. Harrington now at center ice.
A big play there by Harrington on Mushkin. Not only the loss of a scoring opportunity, but also the fact that it gets Mushkin a little bit into the game without discouraging him on his first real opportunity.
This is Maltsev now being hounded by Schneider, and Ramsey is able to take the puck away from him with 11 and a half minutes to play in the second period. The Soviets on top 3-2. Ramsey. And over the blue line, Mike, 19 years old, youngest player on the team, number 1 draft choice at Buffalo. And a whistle on a faceoff in front of the Soviet goaltender, Mushkin. So halfway through the second period, it's the Soviets 3, the United States 2. The Soviet Union on top 3-2, halfway through the second period, Zhluchkov. Corner, Craig out back of the net to stop it. Zhluchkov centering it out in front. Sportsov shot. They got a piece of it.
It's the kind of play the U.S. team has to avoid. They were in pretty good shape. They were in control of the puck, and then they lost it.
Zhluchkov ridden out of the play by Aruzioni. The Soviets with Pervukin losing it to Kristoff. And Kristoff, as he skates in, offside. Dennis. 10 minutes and 45 seconds remaining. We're in the second period. The Soviet Union leading the United States 3-2. Wells on the faceoff for the U.S. Ramsey losing it, but it's picked up by Rakota at his own blue line. Now the Soviets at center ice. Vasiliev to Harlamov. Into the corner now Petrov, scrapping for it with Wells. That's Strobel, number 19. And Morrow to try to come out of his own end now. Number 3, Kenny out of Bowling Green. Up ahead, it's kept in by Harlamov. Craig coming out of the net. Craig now will try to pin it against the boards. The puck is still loose, and now finally Craig is able to cover up. Oh, it could have been a dangerous play as Petrov gets into it with Ramsey. Ramsey dropping his stick. So Petrov and Ramsey broken apart.
Periodically, we make comments about how international rules differ from NHL rules. You saw an instance there where Jim Craig fell on the puck behind the goal line. If that happened in the National Hockey League, and if he was unpressured as he was there, or was unpressured directly, it would have been a penalty for delay of game. In this particular instance, in international hockey, there's no penalty.
10 minutes and 10 seconds remaining, and now Kisla. The official from Finland apparently has given a penalty to the United States. The door of the penalty box is open. The clock says 2 minutes.
I guess Jim Craig and I didn't know the rule. It appears as if he's getting a penalty for delaying the game.
That is the case with Craig. And the penalty will be served by number 19, Eric Strobel. So again, the Soviets with a power play opportunity.
Had he been directly pressured, had a Soviet player been pushing with him, fighting for the puck and so on, that would not have been a penalty. But as it was, he just fell on the puck behind the goal line.
So the Soviets with another power play opportunity. Their veteran line, Harlamov, Petrov out there. But Johnson at center ice. Johnson in over the blue line. Johnson to Schneider, but Buzz couldn't get good wood on the puck. And the shot goes wide as the Soviets come quickly back the other way with Harlamov, number 17, in over the blue line. Harlamov skating around Ramsey, back to the net. Harlamov looking to center, comes out in front to Fedosov. His shot is knocked down by Johnson, and Mark able to clear the zone again. Johnson over on the left side to Schneider. Taken away by Petrov. Mikhailov now to Harlamov. Harlamov centering to Petrov out in front. His shot was blocked in front. Kasatinov to Harlamov again. Harlamov centering pass. Fedosov couldn't get his stick on it. Keeping it in. Out in front to Harlamov. And then shot in. It's wide by Harlamov as he goes over to get it in the corner to Kasatinov. Down number 7. Kasatinov out in front. Schneider knocking it down in front. And Johnson back for the Americans. Johnson trying to clear the zone and does by passing it down the ice with 9:02. Remaining in the period and 50 seconds left in the penalty.
U.S. team was very fortunate there. They were running around in their own defensive zone, particularly defenseman Mike Ramsey, who has been going out to the point, going into the corner much too much. He's got to maintain his position in front of the net.
Davey Christian now. Christian clearing it down the ice. Got to lead up a few more seconds. And Broughton sweeping in. Back of the net. Broughton keeping it in with 25 seconds remaining in the penalty to Eric Strobel. Golikov back the other way for the Soviets. Up ahead to Makarov. Kasatinov at the point. Off the skate of Christian. Baker trying to pin it and does with only 7 seconds now remaining in the penalty. So effectively thus far the Americans have killed 153 of the 2 minute penalty to Craig, which is being served by Strobel.
Here we have the play previously with Mark Johnson finding Buzz Schneider, but his shot just goes wide. The U.S. team has got to capitalize on their opportunities. They've had very few, but they've had two good ones this period with the breakaway by Harrington and that particular two-on-one. The Soviets will not give you that many chances. The ones that you get, you're going to have to score on.
The Americans now with Johnson, McClanahan, Baker, and Christian as they try to eat up the remaining 7 seconds of the penalty. Key faceoff here. Control.